What better way to welcome players to your new website than to show them their brand new profile pages? One of the coolest features of Sports Press is that each player will have their own player profile page filled with their own stats, and it's completely automated. Now let's go ahead and add some players. We can edit the players that already exist or create them from scratch. We'll go ahead and add a new one by going to Players and Add New. I'll go ahead and add myself, so for the name, I'll enter Isla. Don't worry about the excerpt bit, we'll skip that. And let's give this profile a little description. Hi, my name is Isla and I like to play soccer. We can also add more to our profile using the tools that are provided as we would to any WordPress post or page. If we select the different performance metrics and statistics from the column section, we'll be able to view these things within our player profile. Just keep in mind that we don't need to show all of these metrics and stats if we don't want to. You can pick and choose the ones you want to display. For this example, let's go ahead and select all the stats to my profile which will be automatically updated based on my performance during each game. We can assign a player a number, so I'll just add 23 to mine. Now for each player profile, you're going to be asked to select a nationality, the positions, their current team, the past teams that they've played for, the competitions the player participates in, and the seasons. Some metrics if you'd like to display them, and a photo. This attribute section that contains a box labeled order is for ordering our players in a particular manner. This value goes from smallest to largest, so let's say we want this player to show up first. We'd enter the number 1. We can also enter a negative value if we want players to show up before all the default player profile pages, which have a value of 0. Go ahead and click Publish, which will create the player profile. Once we've published, we'll notice that a statistics table has been populated with our seasons and stats from the column section. We can now select the team our player played in for that season in a given league. The teams will only be displayed if that team belongs to that particular league and season. If it's not showing up in here, go back to edit the team and make sure that that team is part of all the leagues and seasons you want them to be in. So in this case, Eagles and Kangaroos are both part of the Premier League in the 2014 season. Once we've selected a team, that role will be displayed in the player profile page. If we haven't specified a team yet, that role will not show up in the player profile page. If we ever want to add new items to the positions, competitions, seasons, metrics, and columns, we can head on over to Sports Press and the Configure page, where we have full control over what's displayed in the drop-down menus. We can choose to show the team or not by clicking on the checkbox above the team. We can change the values in our table columns at any time. All throughout Sports Press, we will see grayed out values in these boxes, especially after we've started to enter our own data. These grayed out values are numbers that have been automatically calculated based on the player's performance in each event. In this example, they are just dashes because we haven't calculated anything yet. But once we start to enter our own data, there should be a number value that is displayed. If we don't like the number that's there, we can just type in the value we want and it will override the grayed out value automatically.